friends, welcome back again. Friends, in this session we are going to discuss about resonance energy. Okay, sometimes you must have seen the question that they ask you to determine, not exactly determine, they ask you to compare the resonance energy of the given molecule. Okay, in the question it is given. So what is resonance energy, first of all? Okay, so resonance energy, the definition you write down, it is the energy difference between the, it is the energy difference between the resonance hybrid and it is the energy difference between the resonance hybrid and the most stable resonance structure. Okay, we know what, that the resonance hybrid has the least energy. Okay, this information we already have, we have already discussed this, that the resonance hybrid, out of all the resonating structure, it is the combination of all the resonating structure, right? Resonance hybrid is the combination of all resonating structure and it has least energy among all the RS resonating structure. Okay, this is for sure. Okay, for example, you see, if I write down this, CH3 C double bond O O minus, suppose the molecule is A, right? And in this, obviously, resonance is possible, conjugated system, right? So other resonating structure will be what? CH3 C single bond O minus double bond O. This is supposed B, right? And for this, if I draw the resonance hybrid, so these are what? These are RS. Resonance hybrid is what? CH3 C double bond O, sorry, single bond O O, and we have partial double bond character here like this, delta negative and delta negative, or we can also say minus half charge will be there. Okay, so this is RH, resonance hybrid, or the real structure. Okay, and this, suppose I am assuming this as C, right? So we know the fact here, and the fact is the energy of C, right, which is the resonance hybrid here, it is less than the energy of A or B, right? Because it is the real hybrid RH and this is the resonating structure RS. Okay, if I draw the energy profile here, energy profile, that could be something like this. This is suppose the energy axis we have, and A and B has the same energy. A and B has the same energy, equal resonance we have. So energy of A and B are same, but energy of C is lesser than the energy of A and B. right? So this difference here, this difference is the resonance energy. Right? So resonance energy RE is equals to, we can write energy of A or B minus the energy of C. This is the resonating structure. Okay. Now the point is, this is the theory part. How do we identify or compare the resonance energy in the given molecule? Okay. So comparison of resonance energy. Comparison of resonance energy. First of all, you see this structure, if it is more stable, okay, more stable structure will have lesser energy, and hence the difference in energy will be more, and hence the resonance energy will be more. Okay, so more stable structure will have the higher resonance energy. Okay, if you have more stable structure, its resonance energy will be high. Okay, so first case that we are comparing here is in case of, we have 6-7 cases possible. So first case I am discussing, in case of aromatic, non-aromatic, and anti-aromatic system. We know the order of stability is what? Aromatic, then non-aromatic, then anti-aromatic. Okay. So the same sequence will have for resonance energy. The order of resonance energy RE will be equals to, it will be maximum for aromatic compound. Then we have non-aromatic compound. And the last we have anti-aromatic. Okay, so if the compound given is aromatic, anti-aromatic or non-aromatic, so simply aromatic compounds will have the maximum resonance energy, then non and then anti. For example, you see these three compounds, if you have to compare, obviously you see this compound is aromatic, this is non-aromatic, and this is anti-aromatic. Okay, aromatic with 6 pi electron, anti-aromatic with 4 pi electron. Okay, so resonance energy will be maximum for aromatic compound, and then we have non-aromatic compound, and then we have anti-aromatic compounds. Okay. So if you have simple compounds which is aromatic, non-aromatic, anti-aromatic, we'll compare the resonance energy as per their stability. Okay. But what happens if the two molecules are aromatic or anti-aromatic in nature, or even non-aromatic? For example, you see second case I will take, if the compound is aromatic or non-aromatic, or anti-aromatic. Any one of these three. If all the compounds given are aromatic or non-aromatic or anti-aromatic. In this case, what happens? The resonance energy RE is directly proportional to the conjugation. More conjugation, more will be the resonance energy. For example, you see this is aromatic, this one, Okay, you see this is aromatic in nature, 2 pi electron. This is also aromatic in nature, 6 pi electron. Okay, more conjugation, more will be the resonance energy. For example, you see both are non-aromatic. Okay, this is also non-aromatic and this is also non-aromatic. More conjugation, more will be the resonance energy. Okay, now third case. The third case is compound shows equal resonance. Shows equal resonance, has more resonance energy. Compound shows equal resonance, has more resonance energy. Now the first thing is, what is equal resonance? Equal resonance we have already discussed, and we call it as equal contributors also. The compound in which we'll get equal contributors, right? Remember when we were discussing the application of resonance, we have classified resonating structure into two types, equal and unequal contributors, and then we have discussed also bond order to calculate, right? So whenever the molecule shows equal resonance, its resonance energy is more. For example, you see, if I write down this one, CH3 C double bond O, O minus, and CH2 C double bond O, OH. CH2 C double bond OH will write here. Okay, so this molecule shows equal resonance. Equal RS, and hence the stability of this is more here, right? For example, you see O negative S double bond O, O negative double bond O, and S double bond O O negative and a lone pair on the sulfur. Okay, we'll have a double bond here. This shows equal resonance stability, or resonance energy will be more. Okay, very two common examples we have. Two very common examples that we'll see now. Third one, we have benzene and pyrrole. Obviously, benzene has equal resonance, more will be the energy. Okay, one example is this. We have pyridine and again pyrrole. Equal resonance we have here, energy will be more. Okay, so in all these example we have equal RS. Here also we have equal RS. So three possibilities we have discussed: when we have aromatic, non-aromatic or anti-aromatic, then we have either anti-aromatic or non-aromatic or aromatic, then we have this, right? Third is, when the compound shows equal resonance, then the compound which has equal resonance will have more resonance energy. Few examples we have seen. Okay, now the next one we have here is cross conjugation or extended conjugation. Fourth case is cross and extended conjugation. Okay, I'll explain this one with an example. Suppose we have these two molecules. Okay, now here you see this double bond is in resonance with this pi bond also, and it is also in resonance with this pi bond also, right? But with the both pi bond, it cannot, you know, show resonance at the same time. Okay, so what happens, either you can draw resonating his structure here with this pi bond or this pi bond, right? But here you see it is in conjugation 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this is what extended conjugation we have, and this one either like this you can draw or this way and this way, because here you see the conjugation is not extending beyond this point. Okay, here also conjugation is not extending beyond this point. So we have a sp3 hybridized carbon in between, right? And these two are not in conjugation with each other. This pi bond is in conjugation with this. This pi bond is in conjugation with this. These two are not in conjugation with each other. Here you see this two are in conjugation with each other. Means this pi bond, pi electron is delocalized from this point to this point, right? However, this is also not completely delocalized, okay, because again we have one sp3 hybridized carbon atom. So we call it as extended conjugation, and this one is cross. Either way we can go, we cannot go both way. Okay, so in case of extended conjugation, the resonance energy for extended conjugation will be more from the resonance energy of cross conjugation. Okay, so the molecule 2 will have more resonance energy than the first molecule. Similar examples, you see we can draw a few more. Resonance energy here, it will be more, right? One more example you see, right? So here you see extended and cross, this is the order of resonance energy. So in case of extended and cross conjugation, the resonance energy is more for extended conjugation. Okay, fifth case you see, that is overlapping tendency. What it means, the difference in the size of orbital increases bond energy decreases, and hence the resonance energy RE decreases. Okay, so if you have, suppose 2p pi and 2p pi bond. So 2p pi bond gives more bond energy, resonance energy, than 2p pi, 3p pi, or 2p pi, 4p pi, or 2p pi, 5p pi. Okay? For example, you see. Okay, so here you see it is in resonance, but here we have 2p, 2p, here we have 2p, 3p, 2p, 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 3p, 2p, 3p, 2p, 4p, right? So this has more resonance energy than this molecule because we have better overlapping than this. Again, oxygen carbon, carbon sulfur, better overlapping here, more will be the bond energy. Carbon chlorine, carbon bromine, carbon chlorine has 2p, 3p, and carbon bromine has 2p, 4p overlapping. Resonance energy will be more in the case of chlorine. Okay, so this is, we'll compare here when the difference in orbitals are involved, right? 2p, 3p, 2p, 4p, like this. If you have 2p, 2p orbital, then we'll compare on the basis of electronegativity. Means when the size and the overlapping tendency is not there, when the size of the orbital is exactly same, right? And in that case, we'll see electronegativity. Okay, that is the next case we have that we'll discuss. See why this happens here, because you see the size of 2p orbital is suppose this, and 3p orbital will be this. 4p orbital will be this, 5p orbital will be this, right? You see the overlapping tendency is very less because of size difference here. It is very difficult to overlap here or with this or with this, even with this or with this, right? So because of this difference in size, the overlapping is not easy, not possible, okay? And that is why the bond energy is less and resonance energy is also less. Okay. The next one is electronegativity. This will apply when the size of overlapping orbital is same, then we define resonance energy on the basis of electronegativity. Okay, so what we can say here, less electronegative, more the tendency of losing electron right. If the electronegativity of the atom is less, right, if the electronegativity of the atom is less, it has more tendency to lose electron, which also increases, hence resonance energy is more. Right? Basically, you have to see the atom with lower electronegativity. For that, the resonance energy will be more. Okay, but this we can only apply when the size of overlapping orbital is same. It means we have either 2p-2p orbital is getting overlap or 3p-3p. We cannot compare this electronegativity thing. We cannot take this, you know, factor into account when the size in orbit, difference in orbital is there. Like here we do not assume that. Okay, so for example, you see this two molecule, right? Nitrogen being less electronegative, resonance energy is more. Resonance energy is more for this, less for the first one. Okay, there's a mistake, we have a double bond here, then only the resonance is possible. Okay, this molecule OH NH2. CL. Resonance energy you have to compare. Okay, so here you see we have 2P overlap. This is again 2P overlap, and this is 2P 3P overlap. Right, 2P 3P overlap. Okay, so the size factor is dominating here. Right, so obviously here the resonance energy will be least. Third number is this. This two same orbital we have will compare electronegativity. Nitrogen is less electronegativity, electronegative first, and then OH is second. One more example we'll see. This two. Here we have 2P 2P, 2P 3P. So obviously oxygen will have more resonance energy than sulfur. Okay, so the point is, factor you see here, if size difference is there, we'll consider that. Okay, but we have then size difference, electronegative difference also we have, then here this one is the minimum, these two will compare on the base of electronegativity. Okay, so electronegativity we only compare when we have equal size of the orbital. Right, here we are considering the overlapping concept. Okay, so this is the next factor we have. We have one or two effects that actually affects the, you know, resonance energy of the molecule, and the last one we have here is the Fries rule. Okay, what is this rule? That if the molecule has more number of benzenoid form then its resonance energy will be more. More number of benzenoid form gives you more resonance energy. For example, you see we have anthracene. This molecule is anthracene. This molecule. It is phenanthracene. Phenanthracene. Okay. So if you see this molecule here, we have two benzenoid form. But here we have 1, 2, 3. Three benzenoid form. So more benzenoid form, more will be the resonance energy. So resonance energy of A is more than to that of B. This is B. Okay, So on the basis of number of benzenoid form, we can compare resonance energy. One more example we'll see here. Compare these two. A, this is B. Okay, if you draw the resonating structure of this, you will always get two benzenoid form. For this, you will always get two benzenoid form. This one, you see the resonating structure. One of the resonating structure will be like this. Okay, so here we have two, but here we have one benzenoid form, right? The actual number of benzenoid form of this molecule, which is, will be between 1 and 2, but in this it is 100% sure that it will always get two benzenoid form into this. Okay, hence in this case the resonance energy of B is more than to that of A. Okay, so this is how we can compare resonance energy of various molecule depending on aromaticity, non-aromaticity and anti-aromaticity. Okay, if this is the there, these compounds are there, then aromatic compounds are the will have the maximum resonance energy, then non-aromatic and then anti-aromatic. If the molecules all are anti-aromatic or non-aromatic or aromatic, then we'll see the conjugation. More conjugation gives you more resonance energy, right? Next thing is what? Next thing we'll discuss the number of, we'll discuss the overlapping concept. Okay, size in the difference in overlapping is more, then resonance energy is less. Okay, when the overlapping things are same, when size of the atoms are same, we'll check electronegativity, right? We can also check Frye's rule, that is nothing but the number of benzenoid form. Okay, so like this we can compare the resonance energy of various molecule. Okay, so in this session we have discussed all possibility of resonance energy. Next session we are going to discuss the acidic and basic nature of the compounds. Thank you.